Confederate Army was led by General Robert E. Lee. He was one of the most highly respected generals involved in the Civil War. General Lee and his Confederate Army had invaded the Union side of the war, and his plan was to take over Gettysburg. The Battle of Gettysburg would eventually be one of the most decisive battles in the Civil War. If the Confederates would have successfully captured Gettysburg, they would be able to continue moving further and further into Union territory. Lee's plans for the first day of battle was to attack the north side of Gettysburg. His troops were divided into four main groups that were located near the McPherson Ridge, Oak Ridge, and Barlow's Knoll. The battle went on all day with the Confederates unable to take control of these locations at the north side of Gettysburg. The plan for the second day of battle was to attack the south side of Gettysburg. The Confederates were again broke up into four main groups, this time attempting to take control of Cemetery Ridge, Cemetery Hill, and Culp's Hill. These were strong defensive positions held by the Union Army. This picture shows the attack points on the Union flanks. The third day battle plan was an all-out offensive on the Union strongholds on the south side of Gettysburg. This was the Confederates' last chance to defeat the Union Army. These attempts failed, and the Confederate Army was forced to retreat, thus ending further movement north into Union territory. The number of Confederate men killed, wounded, or missing was about 23,231 soldiers.
It's better that you know. Don't stop looking, you're